Sleesman, Blue Collar Outdoors. And today, I'm on by myself after work. Oh yeah, have on. Ain't mess around no more. No pastures. I'm on a tree stand that we like to refer to as a no pressure stand. Now, odds are not too high of actually seeing deer tonight. Although when I parked, I did see deer crossing the road up from me, which those deer hopefully will feed down through this backside of the ridge. We're at that one property again. I'm actually hunting the stand that Hawk and I hunted Sunday morning. Seeing a lot of deer, just too far. But they had no idea we were here. As you can see, we got a real big tree here to cover the setup. Get down in those orchards down there. But it's pretty much hit or miss. They're either gonna come our way, come across here, I might get a 30, 40 yard shot, or they're gonna go up to the food plot. And with the wind, I couldn't get up there and hunt anything up top. This is really, there's two stands I could have hunted with this wind. One we already killed the deer at, so I didn't really wanna go back in there and pressure that too much. I wanna let it cool off before we get back in there. Also, I don't wanna be self-filming and that stand. But this stand right here is perfect. Hopefully we see something. Got to the woods pretty late. It's 4:52. But I don't foresee him moving. It's warm and it's windy. Not ideal hunting conditions at all. That's why I'm in this no pressure stand. I'm either gonna see deer or I'm not, but I'm not putting pressure on the property, and that's the main thing. You can't pressure your good stands and your good chunks of property on days like today. On low chance days, it's just not worth it. We don't risk it. We stay out on the perimeter. I mean, shit, I'm 90 yards from my truck, but it's crazy how many deer will move on the edges. And this is a good edge. I got a creek behind me, creek to my left, ridge in front of me, and the gas line, so we'll see. It's either gonna happen or it ain't. It ain't no biggie. It ain't no biggie. Stay tuned. First thing, they skirted that top of that ridge I was showing you. I didn't try calling, I just wanted to see what they would do. They worked off. Next thing I know, I look up, there's three deer coming. So I got my bow ready, and I couldn't really tell what they were. They come. eyes slowly. The little one was feeding right in front of me. Then two pretty smaller does come through with them. They worked around right in front of me for 20 minutes or so. The next thing I know, I seen them start glancing into the woods here. So I looked over and there was two big doe and two other smaller deer. And those big deer, the big doe got to a tree that I had prearranged. So I got my one pin set to it. And I was trying to wait for the little ones to turn around or look the other way so I could get the camera over on them and get drawn, but the big doe, they just got moving, and I wasn't gonna push it, so they worked up and out. Odds are that's gonna be the last deer we see, but even so, I didn't think I'd see this many deer tonight. The stand's gonna be a hot stand though. Oh man, we didn't let one fly, but what a hunt. This camera doesn't show it too well, but it's getting close to the last light. What a fun hunt that was. It ain't all about killing deer. Some of my best hunts did not include dragging a deer out. One fun hunt indeed. Yeah, this is why we're so hard on doe patrol here. I mean, all these deer, I seen a couple of little deers were button bucks, but it's really hard to get on the bucks when there's this many mature does everywhere. Real hard. If you haven't already, make sure to smash that thumbs up button. Do it for the cocky little button buck here that brought the does down. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell. We upload Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and we're going to try to keep that going all the way through deer season. If it does change, there will be a video acknowledging that. So, you guys know I like keeping you in the loop. I'm going to turn this camera off, sit till dark, and hopefully sneak out here. I didn't spook any of these deer, so there's actually a little deer right over on my left here. But it's Jake Sleesman, Blue Collar Outdoors. And we'll catch you on the next one.